Hey WooCommerce fans, today in this video I want to show you how to set up the Stripe payment gateway to work with WooCommerce, which will allow you to accept payments using the Stripe gateway. So the plugin in order to set up the Stripe payment gateway is completely free. However, Stripe does charge a 2.9% plus 30 cents for every transaction. That's pretty standard in the industry. You'll find the same goes with PayPal and a lot of other payment processors, but Stripe is a really easy and simple to use gateway to set up, and it doesn't cost any extra in order to set it up with WooCommerce. So let's take a look at how to do this. First, I just want to show you that on a checkout page, before you've set up any payment gateways with WooCommerce, you might see something like this at the bottom of your checkout page. It says that there are no available payment methods. Once we set up Stripe, then you will have a payment method that will show up down here and you'll be able to accept those payments. The first thing we need to do is log into our WordPress admin area, and we need to go to plugins and add new. We're going to do a search for the WooCommerce Stripe payment gateway. Like I said, this is a free plugin, but there are a few other ones out there. Please take note, and we're going to use the one by Automattic. Automattic is the parent company that bought WooCommerce, so this is one of the more official Stripe plugins. You'll also notice it has one of the highest ratings as well as more active installs than some of the other ones out there. So this WooStripe add-on and this WooCommerce add-on down here, we're not going to be using those, so make sure that you use the one by Automattic. So I've already have it installed here on my site, but just go ahead and you can click install and then make sure that that plugin is activated. Once you've activated the WooCommerce Stripe Payment Gateway plugin, you'll be able to go to WooCommerce and Settings. From here, we're going to go to Checkout. And you should have another checkout option here for Stripe, so we're going to click on that. Now you'll see this page where you'll have some setup options for this plugin. And you'll also be asked for some additional information that you need to get from the Stripe dashboard. So we will have to set up a Stripe account if you have not done that yet. And you can do that by going to stripe.com. Taking a look at these options that we have for Stripe, the very first thing we want to make sure we do is check this box to enable it. If we don't check that box, then none of these settings will matter and we still won't have any payment methods that are available to our customers. So check that box to enable it. Next is the title. This is what's going to show up at the bottom of your checkout page. This is what you want that customer to see in terms of what options they choose. If you enable multiple different payment options up here, let's say you have PayPal as well as check payments and Stripe, you'll have three different options there for the customer at the bottom. So we want to just give them a title here so they know which option they're choosing. This description will just give a little bit more information about what that option is. Test mode is going to enable us to do test transactions through Stripe. This is good for when you're first setting things up, but as soon as you go live with your site, you'll want to uncheck this and you'll not want to be in test mode. These next four boxes here are the information that we need to get from stripe.com once we've set up our account. So Stripe will provide us with secret key and a publishable key. So I'm going to head over to Stripe's website right now and show you where to grab those keys. Once you log into your Stripe dashboard, you'll see a screen that looks like this. I'm going to come up here to my account and click on Account Settings. From here, I'll choose the API keys option. And here you will see the same four fields that the plugin asks you for. We can go ahead and highlight everything there and then paste them in back on our plugin page. Please be careful when entering these keys. Just notice that the test keys start with SK underscore test and the live ones start with SK underscore live. Here in Stripe's dashboard, they show you the test keys first and the live keys second. On your WordPress site, for the Stripe settings, the live keys are first and the test keys are second. So this is kind of being shown in reverse. So just make sure that you copy the correct ones and paste them in the correct area. There are a few additional options here on this page. One is for capture, and it asks if you want to capture the charge immediately. In most cases, you're going to want to do this. That just means that that customer's card is going to be charged right away. You do have the option, if you don't want to capture it right away, it'll go into Stripe and you'll have to manually approve it later, and you'll have up to, I think, 7 days where you'll need to do that. Otherwise, that will not be able to, you won't be able to capture that charge anymore after 7 days. But for most sites, you're going to want to just go ahead and capture that immediately, which means as soon as they put their credit card info in and hit submit or buy or checkout, then you will charge their credit card right away. So most people are going to want to check that box. Stripe Checkout is a different kind of feature that opens up a modal window and tries to simplify the checkout process a little bit. I'm not going to cover that in this tutorial, but I will create something separate that shows you what the Stripe Checkout feature will do. So I was going to create a separate video for you guys on the Stripe Checkout option here. I thought it did a little bit more than it actually does, but it's pretty simple and straightforward, so I'll cover it here. If you check this box to enable Stripe Checkout, what it's going to do is essentially just kind of change the layout of your checkout page. So you do have a few additional options. I'm just going to leave these all as the default. This is your language setting here. You can change that if you have a different language on your site. You can update this right here if you want to enable Bitcoin. I'm going to leave that unchecked. And then you can optionally provide a checkout image. It's not necessary, but it'll show up on the little modal window that appears. So once you enable that, just click Save Changes. I'm just going to jump over to my checkout page again and show you what this looks like. So instead of having the form fields right here on the page, you'll have them in a modal window that pops up when you can click this Continue to Payment button. So it's asking for exactly the same information, it's just doing it in a different form. So you may want to test this out, and if one converts better than the other, then I would go with that option. Saved cards, pretty simple. If you want to save cards, this will happen on Stripe's servers, not on your own web servers, so that's important to note. Just in terms of protecting the customer information, all of this saving of cards will happen on Stripe server if you want to do that. But if you don't have any need for recurring payments or customers that are coming back all the time, then you can just leave this unchecked and you will not save any credit card information on Stripe servers. And this is just for messages. If you're having some problems with the plugin and you need some support, you reach out to Stripe or WooCommerce, go ahead and choose to log these debug messages. That might give you a better idea of what's going on if you're having some problems with the plugin. So once you've customized those settings, entered in all of your keys, go ahead and make sure you click Save Settings at the bottom. And now Stripe should be set up and ready to go. And let's jump over to the checkout page that I showed you earlier. You'll see here at the bottom, it has the order total. And now instead of that message where there's no payment options available, here you'll see we just have the one payment option, and it does say debit credit card. So this is the Stripe Gateway that we just enabled. So now your users will be able to enter in a test card number, their expiration date, and the security code on the back, and click place order. So now your Stripe plugin is all ready to go. Just remember, this note right here is showing you that we still have test mode enabled, and so you can use this card number and then any security code that you want, and you'll be able to just do a test transaction to make sure that things worked okay and that the plugin is set up properly. But again, as soon as you are ready to go live, make sure that you uncheck this box in your settings to disable the testing mode, and that'll make things live for your customers, and you will no longer see this test mode enabled message. You'll just have a card number, an expiration, and a security code. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or any problems setting this up, please leave a comment and I'll do my best to help you out.